Hello, everyone. In the previous episode, I briefly explored science's perspective on death. Let's continue with the book review of Death of Death today. I've looked into aging in various animals such as Caenorhabditis elegans, Drosophila, and Ames dwarf mice. It was found that aging is delayed, and healthy lifespan is extended. If we can uncover the fundamental mechanisms that prevent or reverse aging, it might be possible to delay or even reverse human aging. While we may not be at that stage yet, gaining more knowledge about aging could lead to better management of age-related frailties such as cancer, cardiovascular diseases, type 2 diabetes, and Alzheimer's disease. Aging varies depending on the reproductive type. Animals with asexual reproduction, where somatic cells produce offspring independently without the fusion of gametes, tend to have slower aging. Environmental conditions also play a significant role. For example, lowering the temperature and restricting food intake can extend the lifespan of flies and worms. In Caenorhabditis elegans, genes called AGE1 and DOF2, as well as the FOXO gene in Drosophila melanogaster, have been found to regulate some aspects of the aging process. Aging progresses differently in plants and animals. Some species of perennial plants show minimal or no signs of aging. In humans, the lifespan of sperm is about 3 days, but the germ cells that produce sperm do not age. Colon cells last for about 4 days, skin cells for 2 to 3 weeks, red blood cells for about 4 months, white blood cells for over a year, and certain neurons in the cerebral cortex can last a lifetime. Stem cells in specific brain regions can generate some new neurons. Indeed, in our previous discussion, I mentioned that cancer cells are considered immortal. Unlike many somatic cells, which lose their ability to regenerate once they become a mature adult due to the lack of telomerase production, cancer cells can generate telomerase even in the adult stage, allowing for continuous regeneration. Long-lived species continue to produce telomerase in somatic cell tissues, yet they have low cancer incidence. Heterocephalus glabra are representative examples. They are believed to have developed alternative mechanisms to prevent cancer while possibly enhancing cellular control. In 1908, Russian-born French biologist Elie Metchnikoff, who was a Nobel Prize laureate in physiology or medicine, explained that not only germ cells but also multicellular organisms could be immortal. He coined the term gerontology, the study of aging, while working alongside Louis Pasteur. British scientist Aubrey de Grey, author of Ending Aging, listed 7 causes of aging: intracellular junk, extracellular junk, nuclear mutations, mitochondrial mutations, stem cell loss, cell senescence, and extracellular crosslinks. In 2005, the MIT Technology Review editor offered a $20,000 prize to experts to disprove this claim, but no one could demonstrate it as false, so the prize became void. Aging is characterized by a gradual decline in physiological integrity, leading to reduced function and increased vulnerability to death. A group of 5 European scientists listed 9 characteristics of aging: genomic instability, telomere shortening, epigenetic alterations, loss of proteostasis, deregulated nutrient sensing, mitochondrial dysfunction, cellular senescence, stem cell exhaustion, and altered intercellular communication. Scientists studying gerontology are demanding that aging should be classified as a disease. The distinction between what is considered normal and what is classified as a disease has evolved over history. For instance, when black slaves escaped from plantations, they were classified as having drapetomania, a mental disorder that led to running away, and medical interventions were used to treat them. Homosexuality was classified as a disease until 1974. Even fever was once considered a disease, but as its fundamental cause became known to be a symptom rather than an illness, it changed from being classified as a disease to being recognized as a symptom. Conditions that are currently considered diseases, such as osteoporosis, isolated systolic hypertension, and late-onset Alzheimer's, were once regarded as normal aging processes in the past. If aging is recognized as a disease, it would lead to not only health insurance benefits but also an increase in the development of anti-aging drugs, regenerative medicine, and precision medical approaches. Many business models related to aging therapy would likely emerge as well. However, the current medical system does not perceive the aging process as the underlying cause of chronic diseases affecting the elderly. As a result, in the United States, about 32% of the healthcare spending within the health insurance system does not significantly improve the quality of life for patients in the last 2 years of their lives, despite being affected by chronic diseases. In 2018, the World Health Organization, WHO, finally approved the ICD-11 code for promoting aging treatment and prevention strategies related to age-related diseases, but it did not officially recognize aging itself as a disease. The current ICD-12 is under review regarding this matter. OpenAI CEO Sam Altman said this in 2018, "If we create a pill that extends one person's lifespan by 2 years, it will become a $100 billion company." Treating aging as a disease may seem impossible, but there have been numerous cases in the past where technologies that seemed impossible became essential. Even top experts were skeptical of groundbreaking technologies at the time. For instance, the advent of airplanes was met with skepticism, and it was deemed impossible until it became a reality. Many experts, including articles in the New York Times, emphasized its impossibility. William Thomson, the Scottish physicist and mathematician also known as Lord Kelvin, famously said in 1902, "Heavier-than-air flying machines are impossible." In 1920, the New York Times covered space travel in an editorial, stating, "Professor Robert H. Goddard, the pioneer of rockets, does not know the relation of action to reaction and of the need to have something better than a vacuum against which to react. He seems to lack the basic knowledge ladled out daily in high schools." Personal computers were unimaginable, and even Thomas Watson, IBM legend, said in 1943, "I think there is a world market for maybe 5 computers." There is an opinion that anti-aging treatments could potentially add several decades to human lifespans and help offset the global economic decline caused by an aging population. As mentioned earlier, George Church, a genetics professor at Harvard Medical School, is conducting experiments on reversing aging in animals, specifically dogs, at Rejuvenate Bio, with the aim of eventually applying the research findings to humans. He stated this in a Washington Post op-ed. "The planned goal is for everyone to receive gene therapy not only for rare diseases like cystic fibrosis but also for common ailments like aging. If elderly individuals can return to work feeling healthy and youthful, we can prevent one of the greatest disasters in history, which is aging. The younger generation should replace you, but you are the one who will do it. I will gladly do so." In 2010, Craig Venter, an American biochemist, geneticist, and entrepreneur who co-founded Celera Genomics, gained worldwide attention for creating the first synthetic bacteria. The first self-replicating species on Earth to have a computer as its parent was named Cynthia. Venter co-founded Human Longevity Inc. In 2016, Venter's research team succeeded in synthesizing a bacterial genome consisting of 473 genes. Cynthia Kenyon, an expert in aging, stated in her paper titled "The Last Frontier of Aging" the following: "People might assume that many genes, including those influencing muscle strength, wrinkles, and dementia, need to change to extend lifespan. However, through studies on worms and mice, we made a remarkable discovery. By altering a few genes, we can delay aging for the entire organism at once." Laura Deming, a New Zealand-born American scientist and investor, started working as an intern in Cynthia Kenyon's California lab. She enrolled at MIT at the age of 14 but dropped out in 2011. As one of the first recipients of Peter Thiel's $100,000 fellowship, Deming became a beneficiary of his startup support. Focusing on aging and lifespan extension, Deming established the venture capital firm called the Longevity Fund. After Laura Deming created the Longevity Fund, in 2021, 5 venture funds and venture builders, including Kazoo Technology Capital, announced commitments for new funds each exceeding $100 million. Vita Dow raised $5 million in Ethereum, while Altos Labs, with participation from Yuri Milner and Jeff Bezos, has been actively involved in longevity funds, utilizing Coinbase and other cryptocurrency platforms. Ethereum co-founder Vitalik Buterin is also investing in health and longevity using cryptocurrencies. The longevity industry has grown from being worth a few million dollars in the early 21st century to several billion dollars recently, and it is projected to grow to trillions of dollars in the 2030s and 2040s. Artificial intelligence is also contributing to longevity. Sundar Pichai, the CEO of Google, stated, "AI is one of the most profound things that humanity is working on. It's more profound than electricity or fire." The artificial intelligence network called AlphaFold, developed by Google's DeepMind in 2020, successfully solved one of the most complex problems in biology, which is predicting protein folding. The renowned scientific journal Nature described it as a breakthrough that will change everything. Proteins, the building blocks of life, have a three-dimensional structure formed during the folding process, and this folding process holds crucial information about health. Predicting the unique folding structure for each protein was a challenging task due to its complexity. IBM, Google, Amazon, Apple, Meta, General Electric, Intel, Microsoft, and others are developing artificial intelligence that will soon be ready for clinical applications. Additionally, Chinese companies like Baidu and BGI, Beijing Genomics Institute, are also developing artificial intelligence with a focus on disease detection and genome sequencing. Sequencing refers to the project of determining the order of gene sequences. According to market research firm CB Insights, the fastest growing field in artificial intelligence applications is the healthcare sector, with the highest level of investment and venture capital focus. The widespread adoption of new personal sensors, including medical sensors, has enabled the utilization of big data. Both large corporations and small startups are entering the healthcare sector, thanks to technologies like deep learning and other machine learning algorithms. Companies utilizing machine learning algorithms and predictive analytics are shortening the drug development period, providing virtual medical services to patients, and processing medical images for disease diagnosis. The number of such companies is significantly increasing. We will conclude today's video here, and in the next episode, I will explore another life extension plan known as cryonics, which involves the preservation of bodies through freezing, as well as the birth through donation of a 30-year-old frozen embryo, and the debate surrounding technologies aimed at slowing down the aging process. Thank you for watching so far.